Thank you. Yes.
Oh, we need it. I saw it.
Good morning, and Gong Hei Fa Choi. Welcome to the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception. Today we celebrate the third Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is Father Michael Cudigan. Please join the choir in singing the entrance hymn, All the Earth Proclaim the Lord.
Oh,
Kong Hei Fa Choi, San Tai Ken Hong. You don't know how long I've been practicing that this past week. Yes, we have greeted each other in the Chinese language for the Year of the Rabbit, but we now transform that human greeting into the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord of mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ of mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord of mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you.
We bless you.
We adore you.
We glorify you.
We give you thanks
for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone art the Holy One, you alone art the Lord, you alone art the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word. The first reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. In this passage, the prophet predicts future liberation for an oppressed people.
First, the Lord degraded the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. But in the end, he has glorified the seaward road, the land west of the Jordan, the district of the Gentiles. Anguish has taken wing, dispelled its darkness, for there is no gloom where but now there was distress. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The responsorial psalm is Psalm 27. The response is, "The Lord is my light and my salvation."
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid? One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple. I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
The second reading is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. In this reading, Paul launches a passionate appeal for unity in the community at Corinth.
I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of you agree in what you say, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be united in the same mind and the same purpose. For it has been reported to me about you, my brothers and sisters, by Chloe's people, that there are rivalries amongst you. I mean that each of you is saying, I belong to Paul, or I belong to Apollos, or I belong to Cephas, or I belong to Christ. Is Christ divided? Was Paul crucified for you? Or were you baptized in the name of Paul? For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel, and not with the wisdom of human eloquence, but that the cross of Christ might not be emptied of its meaning. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
Jesus proclaimed the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the people.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went to Capernaum so that what had been said through Isaiah might be fulfilled. When Jesus heard that John had been arrested, he withdrew to Galilee. He left Nazareth and went to live in Capernaum by the sea, in the region of Zebulun and Naphtali, that what had been said through Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled. Land of Zebulun and land of Naphtali, the way to the sea beyond the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who sit in darkness have seen a great light. On those dwelling in a land overshadowed by death, light has arisen. From that time on, Jesus began to preach and say, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." As he was walking by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who's called Peter, and his brother Andrew, casting a net into the sea. They were fishermen. He said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." At once they left their nets and followed him. He walked along from there and saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets. He called them, and immediately they left their boat and their father and followed him. He went around all of Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and curing every disease and illness among the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning again to all of you. And more specifically, we as a community say good morning to all of you, our brothers and sisters, who are at home because of illness or age or whatever reason. And our situation here of people here in the cathedral and people at home, we need to listen, because the first reading is a reminder to us that the Lord will send the light and will make all the different peoples back into one people. It was a time when Isaiah made this prophecy that the people were in a bad way. They were discouraged. They were afraid. They were in captivity, enslaved by their sinfulness. And their society was falling apart. And then the Lord spoke to his people, as he's speaking to each one of us today, that a new light would come. And this light, as we know now in the gospel, was to be found and fulfilled in the person of Jesus. And we need his light. Because as we begin this new year, Chinese New Year, I reflect back on this past year. And there were a couple of insights that came to me. One, we need each other. We need to see and receive the witness of each other's faith life. I usually come to pray here in the afternoon, and it struck me that one of the reasons I do, because maybe you might have up to 100 people here attending Mass and saying their prayers, it's an inspiration to me, a reminder to me that yes, there is a God who loves us. There is a God who cares for us, who's concerned about us. And then there were other people I met, and they were discouraged, and they were afraid. And they were saying, where is God? He has deserted me in my troubles, in my sickness and worries. And of course, the simple reason was that their faith had become weak, and they had lost the regular contact with their God. That is why it's so important that we gather here on a Sunday on a regular basis to know that there is a God who loves us, that there is a God who is with us. As Jesus said, wherever two or three are gathered in my name, there am I. And we need to be reminded of that, because there's so many distractions and worries and whatever in our life. We need to remember that Jesus is the light that came to guide us, to encourage us, to help us to look beyond the current situation, whatever that may be troubling us. To be reminded that we are not alone, that our God is with us, the light who came in the person of Jesus to proclaim the good news of God's love for his people, to bring healing, and most importantly, to renew the hope of the people at that time who were totally devastated and enslaved in their fear. The light of Christ. We need to leave to let the light of Christ, as in Christ himself, into the darkest areas of our life where we are ashamed or afraid to look at because of what we may have said or done in the past. What we are being invited to do is to focus on the person of Jesus, our light, our hope, our life and our love. Because if we don't have Christ, then two things can happen. One, we become totally caught up in our fear of God's punishment for all our failings. We lose hope. We spend so much time focusing on the darkness of our life that the darkness actually takes us over, and we cannot see that the light of Christ is with us, that no matter what we do, God still loves us. He is our strength and our rock. And I read or heard just the other day that, and I thought it was really nice, God is forgetful. He is forgetful of the little incidentals of our goodness or our badness, our weaknesses or our strength. All God sees is ourselves. We who are sometimes confused and lost, and yet people of goodwill. And the Lord came to save us. And that is why Jesus called his apostles to proclaim the good news that God's love was not unattainable or so far away that it was not reachable. So this year of the rabbit, there's good news. And any good news we have reflects something of the good news that we have the light of Christ in our lives and with us. And we know what happens with in the darkness. People become afraid. We're afraid that somebody will break into our apartment. Hence we have CCTV television, cameras and all that. But when the light is there, all is revealed. A little bit like in a sunny morning here in the cathedral when the sun shines in from through the gallery above. And I can see all your beautiful faces. But in a dark day, wet day, you're all just a blur. I think what the Lord does for us, he helps us to see reality as it really is, that we not only need him in our lives, but we need one another. As the saying goes, no person is an island. We depend on one another. Because without others in our life, there's a certain incompleteness there. So as we begin this new year of the rabbit, let us rejoice and be glad that our God is with us and he's calling us back. It is always a calling back to us. Come back. You are loved by me. I did not come to punish you, but to that you may have the light ahead of you as in Jesus to guide and be your hope and joy and love. That we may have increasing faith, hope and love in our lives. And that is my prayer and wish for each one of you today. Amen.
Please stand for the profession of faith.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Lord is our light and our help. Let us bring our needs before God with confidence.
The response to today's general intercessions is, Lord, you are my light and my help. Lord, you are my light and my help. For the church, that the power of the Holy Spirit may make it one body, healed of all division, let us pray in faith.
Lord, let us pray in faith.
For all Christians, that the Lord may make them one in the fullness of faith and keep them one in the fellowship of love. Let us pray in faith. Lord,
you are our light and our help.
For all rulers, that Christ, the light of the world, may show them the path to peace. Let us pray in faith.
Lord, you are our light and our help.
For those experiencing the darkness of grief, that Christ's comforting light may brighten their darkness. Let us pray in faith.
Lord, you are our light and our help.
For all gathered here today, that we may live in such a way that as to be good witnesses for the light of Christ. Let us pray in faith.
Lord, you are our light and our help.
For our departed relatives and friends, that the Lord may bring them into the light that no darkness can overpower. Let us pray in faith.
Lord, you are our light and our help.
For our own special needs, let us pray in faith.
Lord, you are our light and our help. Almighty God, may the presence of your light, of your Son, light up our lives and bring us safely through the shadows of this world to our homeland of everlasting light. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please join the choir in singing the offertory hymn, "You Walked Along Our Shoreline." Stand. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with each and every one of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lord,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. Today's communion hymn is One Bread, One Body.
Thank you.
There are two items of parish news this morning. The Cathedral's Society Care Group and Environmental Group would like to invite everyone to participate in the annual event, Cherish Our Food from God. Parishioners can bring gifts received for Chinese New Year, which are unopened, non-perishable, and not yet expired, to church when attending Sunday Mass. The organizers will then deliver the gifts to those in need in our society. A collection counter will be set up outside the parish hall from 9:30 a.m. to 12:45 p.m. on Sundays, January 22nd, 29th, and February 5th. That means today and the next two Sundays. Thank you for your generous support. And the Regina Apostolorum Scholarship for the Formation of Catholic Student Leaders in Universities in Hong Kong is now open for applications. The scholarship will sponsor the cost of attendance at a one-month Catholic study abroad experience during the summer of 2023 and include the opportunity of a three-year mentorship on leadership and community impact. For additional details, please refer to the posters by the church entrance. Please stand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Please join the choir in singing the recessional hymn, How Great Thou Art.